So in this tutorial, we are going to look at Java design patterns, more specifically Singleton design pattern. We are going to cover this following implementations: eager initialization, lazy initialization, and the various types of lazy initialization, and then build for implementation and enum implementation. Then we'll see at the end how we can protect our Singleton from different type of exploitation. So I have created this project. So first we'll see the lazy implementation. So this is our Singleton class. So we are going to look at eager initialization. So this is the simplest one. So in this we'll create the object straight away. Private eager initialization instance equal to new of this, and we'll have the private constructor so that we prevent instantiation of this class, and then we'll have a public method to access the class, this particular object, instance object. Return the instance. That's it. So this is the most simplest implementation. What we did here is we just created the object and then keep it ready, and then the constructor is private so that we prevent, we're not letting others to call this particular constructor. And this should be a static method, and this should be a static instance. Okay, so now if I want to use it, let's say we are printing one object here, public void, say hello. Okay, so we can use it here. Eager initialization dot get instance dot say hello. If we run it, we can see it's building now. Once it builds, it will just print that line. So just said saying hello. The problem with this initialization is we are creating the object at startup itself, so that even though we don't need this, this gets created. Now let's see the other implementation, which will be the lazy initialization. So in this, we'll keep this instance as null, and we will have a private constructor, and we'll create the instance when we need it. So first thing we'll check if objects dot is null instance. If it is null, then create it. Right. This should be this. And then return instance. So this is lazy initialization, but the problem is this is not thread safe. So if in a race condition, if both the threads try to get the instance, it might end up creating two instances. So we can actually make it as synchronized, so that now this is thread shape. The problem with this approach is we are actually excessively synchronizing this whole part, entire method. So let's say if we are creating an instance which is a costly one and it's time consuming to create, so what will happen is all other threads which are actually calling for this get instance will be stuck in this synchronized call. Okay, so let's do other implementation. Lazy initia, it will be like this only. Oh yeah, we have made this private lazy init instance equal to null, and this will be static. Oops. Private, so let's make this constructor private and then public static lazy init get instance. So here dot is null instance, we are actually calling it a synchronized context. And then returning this instance. But problem with this approach is, so let's say first thread comes. In this again, in a single threaded scenario, this works fine. But when you're talking about multi-threaded scenario, this code is broken. So how it is broken? So let's say first thread comes. It sees that, okay, instance is null. So it gets that static lock and then goes inside and try to create the instance. Okay, let's say meanwhile another thread comes, so the first thread is yet to finish its object creation and it's still inside the synchronized block. So second thread comes, second thread will see that object instance is still null because instance is not fully created yet, and then it will, the other thread also will load in the synchronized block. So once the first thread comes out of the synchronized block and release the lock, the second thread will go inside and again create another instance. So this is also broken. So for this we have double checking. So again we create private static double check instance, private double check. So this is to prevent the constructor instantiation. Then we'll have public static double check get instance. Now in this, first thing we'll do a check first. If objects dot is null, if it is null, then it's to a synchronized double check dot class. Right. Then again we'll check if it is null or not. If it is null, then only we will be creating this object, and then here we will return instance. So now this is somehow foolproof. So if again, if you take the earlier example, if one thread, first thread comes, it straight away go inside because there is nothing, and it gets the lock and try to create. If second thread comes, it will see that object is null. Fine, it will load in the synchronized block. And let's say, and until this first thread comes out, the synchronized lock is not available. Now once the first thread comes out, the second thread goes inside and makes this another check, objects.isNull instance, and it sees, okay, the object is created, so it comes out. See, this implementation is still broken, though it looks fine. There are a couple of issues with this approach as well. So maybe you can do Google about it. This is still not the right way to implement Singleton. So we will see the other implementation. So this is a build pow implementation. In this, what we have is, in this, we first thing we will have this. This is a private static, private constructor. Now in this we'll have a private static, a helper class, singleton holder. In this we'll have a private static bell implementation instance equal to new of this. So this is there, and then we will have a public static bell implementation get instance. In this we are going to return what, this singleton holder dot instance. Now this was one of the popular implementation. In this, what we are doing is, see, this is, we are actually not initializing the instance until we are invoking it. So once we are calling this get instance, then only the singleton holder dot instance is getting invoked, and then this particular object get created. So this is not like our eager implementation. We are waiting for it. So all the, and this implementation was quite popular before Java 1.5. Okay, now we're going to see the best implementation, which was suggested by Joshua Block in his book Effective Java. So that is through enum. So enums are actually by default, by design, they are singleton. So we will have, let's say my singleton will have an enum. So here we'll just give instance, that's it. This is singleton by default. So basically enum, whatever is enum instances we are creating, by default Java behind the scene creates the object, and Java ensures that only one instance of that particular type is available. Not only this, these are also protected in terms of serialization and other type of problems. Okay, so these are the type of implementations we have seen. Now in interviews there will be a couple of further questions when the interviewer asks about singleton. So one question will be, so let's have a look at what we have seen here. So how we are going to handle this serialization. So what I can do is, I can actually have this class, I can serialize it, and then in another class I can deserialize it, so that I will have multiple options. So for the solution for this is public, let's say eager initialization, you have to implement the read resolve method, and then you ensure that you are returning the same instance, so that even if you try to deserialize it, you are basically returning the same instance. So this gives us, this protects us with the serialization attacks. Okay, so this is one of the thing. Another thing is reflection. So reflection we can't prevent, basically, even though we are having a private constructor, you know, we can actually break it through reflection. So the best implementation is this one, which we talked about, instance, this enum. You can't actually break it through reflection attacks. Another thing is the cloning. But what if I clone it? What if I try to clone it? So the best option will be to first implement the clonable interface and then overwrite the clone and make throw either you throw the same instance or you if we want we can actually throw this error clone not supported. We can do this or we can optionally we can return the return double check get instance. We can do this as well so that we return the same instance. So this covers all of the things about singletons. We covered that eager initialization, we covered the lazy initialization, then single check, double check, then we have seen the BILPO implementation, then we have seen the enum implementation, we have seen how we can prevent this serialization attack, and then we have seen how we can prevent the reflection attacks, and lastly we have seen how we can prevent the cloning attacks. So if someone try to clone it, we return them the same object. So there is only one instance available. Thank you for watching this video. Hope this helps.